Hello everyone, I hope that you have gone through my previous video on the same chapter that is called The Making of National Movement 1870-1947. In the previous video, we try to understand that what are the different things happened which uprises the many of the movements against the colonial ruler in India. In this video, continuing the chapter, we will try to understand that how the growth of mass nationalism began in our country. It is said that after 1919, the movement against the Britishers or colonial rule become widespread. So what were the reasons that after 1919, the struggle against the colonial ruler become wider? That factors of that point we will try to understand in this chapter. So if you see this phase, then you will come to know that 1914 to 1918, this is the period of First World War. So during the First World War, the colonial ruler or England, it participated. We know that England was the superpower of that time, and when it has participated in the war, it need a huge resources, military supply and financial assistance to participate in the war. So in that conditions, the Britishers, they utilizes a large number of human resource, other resources as well as the money in the warfare. And for that reasons, what happened, they increased the rate of taxation in all those colonies where they are working. As a result, these colonies, they started to face a economic crisis. Okay, what they face? They face a economic crisis. Now there is a shortage of food, there is the price of the food in growing very higher, the inflation is being seen, and many people, they sink in the poverty. So this is how this factor lead to some sorts of disliking for the colonial rulers by the people within the colonies, right? Second thing, if you see that advance of Gandhi, you know that 1915 Mahatma Gandhi returned from South Africa, and Mahatma Gandhi became a popular figure in South Africa after he fought against the racial discrimination. In South Africa, the racial discrimination was in practice, and Gandhiji stood against that and fought against such a social evil which was existing. And that protest of Mahatma Gandhi, the fight of Mahatma Gandhi based on the color, made him popular not only in South Africa but all over the world. So when Mahatma Gandhi returned to India at the age of 42 years from South Africa, at the time, once returning to India, he emerged as one of the very prominent leader of Congress. Congress too was struggling to have a such a leader who would be listened throughout the world. So when Gandhiji back to India, it has given the Congress a ray of hope that now through the Gandhi, the objectives of Congress could be achieved. So in that way, the advance of Gandhi to India from South Africa is also seen as what? One of the factor for the growth of mass nationalism. Another is the passing of Rowlatt Act. In 1919, seeing the uprisings all over the country after the advance of Mahatma Gandhi. If you see 1915 when he returned from South Africa, 1916 he visited Champaran to organize the plantation worker, no? 1917 he visited Kheda to organize the cotton plantation worker. 1918 he visited again Ahmedabad, no, to organize the meal worker. So this frequent visit of Mahatma Gandhi to different part of the country made British rule little worried about the matter. The development of the Congress and how they are organizing the people throughout the country make colonial ruler threatened. Seeing this development, in 1919, the colonial ruler, they passed an Rowlatt Act. Now, what is Rowlatt Act? Rowlatt Act passed by the colonial ruler restrict various freedoms of expressions, freedoms of liberty of the people. Now, passing of Rowlatt Act was declared as what? Black legislation by the Congress. They declared it as a black legislation. Now, this Rowlatt Act did not allow citizen to speak anything against the government. It also did not allow to organize any kind of rallies, form any kind of association, organize any kind of conference. Main motive of the colonial ruler to pass the Rowlatt Act was to restrict the advance of Congress, who are organizing the people against the colonial ruler after the advance of Mahatma Gandhi to the country. Now, passing of Rowlatt Act has brought another happened in the same year. You might be knowing about the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Do you know, after passing of the Rowlatt Act, now Congress has a call for the conference in Jallianwala Bagh, which is in Amritsar, Amritsar of Punjab. Okay, large number of people they gathered in the Jallianwala Bagh to attend the conference, a peaceful conference called by the Congress. Meanwhile, the General Dyer, the Governor General of the Amritsar, come to know about this development. As per the Rowlatt Act, the martial law was in execution. Martial law. What is martial law? Martial law is that which restricts the citizens to move in the group, to organize rallies, to call for any kind of association or conference. Okay? So martial law was in execution, which restrict the people to form or organize any kind of rallies or gathering. Now in the Jallianwala Bagh, when the Congress called for the peaceful conference of the people, at the time Governor General the Dyer has come to know about the development. He reached in the Jallianwala Bagh and surrounded the exit point with his gunmen. Now the Jallianwala Bagh, if you see, it was surrounded by the big walls from all the side, and it has a two gateways for entry and exit. Unfortunately, that day the gate which was used for exit was closed, and only single gate was used by the people. It is fortified with the big walls all around the Bagh. And Jallianwala, when General Dyer reached here in Jallianwala Bagh, he surrounded this site with his gunmen without giving any kind of warning. He has opened fire over the innocent people. Hundreds of thousands innocent Indians were killed by the order of General Dyer, when he gave an order of open fire over these innocent people. In this incident, in this human assassination, so many children, women, old age people, they died. They were running here and there to save their life. In between the Jallianwala Bagh, there was a well. the people to save themselves from the brutal act of General Dyer, they jump in this well. You would be shocking to know that whole the Jallianwala Bagh is colored with the blood of innocent people. This act of British Governor General Dyer was very strongly condemned by the Congress and all the people living around the country. It was one of the world's largest human killing that has happened in the colonial rule in our country. After that also, the Congress has continuously asked the government for apologize on their act. Do you know? You would be shocked to know that in 2019, when the Jallianwala Bagh massacre incident has completed its 100 years, on that very day, the government of Britain has given a written apology to government of India. Now see, this development happened, and because of this, there was a hatred, there was a disliking against the colonial ruler all over the country, and that is another reason which has boosted the mass nationalism in our country. In the same year, 1919, after the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, do you remember what I told? The period of First World War is 1914 to 1918, and officially it is declared war as an end in 1919. In the First World War, when Turkey ruler, or we can say that Balkan Peninsula, it was one of the main causes for the breakout of the First World War. If you see Balkan Peninsula, it is very prosperous geographically, and many of the imperialist power, they want to capture the Balkan Peninsula. In that process, the Turkish ruler, so-called Khalifa, they were very brutally treated by the colonial ruler, the Britishers. Okay. Now, in this entire process, when the Khalifa was captured, and when he was humiliated, and when he was assassinated, this was entire Muslim community of the world, they have condemned, they opposed. They disliked this act of Britishers, and to show their disliking against the Britishers, what they did with the Khalifa in different part of the world, they organized some sorts of protest. Such agitation is lead in India as well. Now, that agitation is called as Khilafat agitation. The idea of Khilafat was adopted in 1919. Okay, the Khilafat idea was come in mind, and it was led by Ali brothers. In history, they were known as Ali brothers. Their name is Shaukat Ali and Muhammad Ali. Shaukat Ali and Muhammad Ali. Now, seeing these uprisings among the Muslim communities, when Ali brothers approached Mahatma Gandhi to support Khilafat agitation, now Gandhiji find it as a very good opportunity to unite Hindus and Muslim. As you know, the majority of the population in the country in those days were Hindu and Muslims. And because of the caste differences, because of the religious differences, these people were not coming jointly together to fight against the British rule. When Ali brothers approached Mahatma Gandhi to support the Khilafat, Gandhiji found it as a very good opportunity to unite Muslims and Hindus. Now, Khilafat ideas was adopted, okay, adopted in 1920. In the same year, the non-cooperation movement idea was also adopted in 1920. You see, 1920, idea of non-cooperation movement was adopted. And in 1921, both Khilafat and non-cooperation movement, Khilafat and non-cooperation movement, just I am using this abbreviation, this is not correct, just to save the time, non-cooperation movement, it was launched all over the country. Do you know, if you see most of the movement initiated by the Gandhiji, it was based on Gandhian ideology. And what is that? That is Satyagraha. What is Satyagraha? Satyagraha means following the path of truth. Following the path of truth. Gandhiji was in opinion, if our reason is genuine, to achieve that, we did not need to use the force. Right? And his ideologies were Satyagraha, non-violence, right? And respecting the sentiment of everyone, Gandhiji launched. So, Satyagraha and Ahimsa and peace. Most of the Gandhijis, why most every of the movement which is organized by Gandhiji, they were based on these three principles, that is Satyagraha, Ahimsa and peace. Now with that, the non-cooperation and Khilafat movement was launched in 1922 all over the country. Now when this Khilafat was launched in different part of the country, what happened? Do non-cooperation was taken or carried in the same way by the people all over the country as Gandhiji was in opinion? To understand that and rest part of the chapter, we are going to make another video. Thank you.